Hello to all of our Gold participants from around the world. Welcome to Gold Learning. I'm Fiona Lang-Sharp, IBCLC and Director of Communications and MC for Gold Learning online conferences. Well, welcome back, everyone. I am so delighted to have all of you here today because I have my guest, Alexandra Glass. She is going to be talking about persistent pain during breastfeeding, a challenge in lactation counseling. Alexandra is going to be part of the Gold Lactation Online Conference 2019, and she is going to be live with us. Today, we're going to be jumping into some of the things that she's going to be talking about, and also, of course, learning a little bit more about what life is like for Alexandra in Hanover, Germany. So welcome, Alexandra. It's great to have you here today.
Hi, Fiona.
Well, tell me, this is a big topic, and there's a lot to cover in this presentation. Can you tell me just a couple of things that you're just really hoping that you will share with the audience when you're with us here at the conference?
Yes, of course. I see a lot of women, as a gynecologist, I see a lot of women that have problems breastfeeding. And of course, these are often women I already know from their pregnancy, but there are not so many gynecologists who are IBCLC, also IBCLCs. So often women come that I haven't known before come to me as patients, and they often have a long history, weeks or even months of pain, problems with breastfeeding and often pain during breastfeeding, and they already did a lot. They went online, they talked to their midwives, they worked with their gynecologists, who often, unfortunately, could not help, not knowing much about lactation, and then they come to me because they heard about me, or they found me online as being a gynecologist and an IBCLC. So they come to me with often weeks of problems, weeks of pain, and we try to work that out together.
That's amazing. And I was just thinking, Alexandra, what a great combination as a physician you have, being an obstetrician and an IBCLC. It's fairly unique, I think. There aren't many of you, but I'm sure there's a lot of appreciation of understanding the history of the mother when she comes to you, because it's not just the immediate situation that you're dealing with, but perhaps there is a challenging birth situation, a cesarean section, or those types of things. So that probably provides you a bit of a backstory to help them move forward. Do you find that that works well for your clients?
Of course, that works well for my clients, and it's a lot of things to find out if I don't know the patient. And they are often surprised how many questions I ask. I don't just ask about what is breastfeeding now, what is your problem now,
right,
what is maybe your baby's problem. I ask about how was birth, how was pregnancy, how you also have to ask general health issues of the patient. It's a lot of things you have to combine, a lot of things you have to think about that can add to this situation the patient is in now.
Yeah, and often being a good detective, as we say, in the lactation field, finding out some of those nuances and behaviors that may have come up in immediately post-birth or in the coming weeks can certainly add to solving some of the problems. I wanted to ask you, of course, this being a clinical topic, and generally speaking, we're always hungry for more solutions and to help with problem solving and understanding ways that we can support women, because we are seeing some quite challenging situations through birth, which of course can have an impact, but also I think women, families, parents, they want to breastfeed longer. And so they're coming back to us more frequently to ask questions. Do you find in your practice that you are seeing the client come back more frequently now and more determined than perhaps years before?
Yes, because they are often desperate. They are desperate, and they often don't have anyone else to talk to ask. So they come back very very often. Yes, of course.
That's excellent.
We
That's one.
and
Yeah.
you most of the time you need more than one meeting to figure out what the problem is or how to end the problem.
Right. Yeah, of course. Of course. Well, I'm really looking forward to your presentation and learning from you and hearing more about some of the things that you've been able to put into practice in your clinic. But now I would like to ask you some questions about you and what else you do in Germany. And perhaps, too, you could let the audience know where in fact, are you in Germany, and have you always lived there?
I am in the northwestern part of Germany. I've been around here most of the time, yes. And I live here with my husband and my two daughters and my cat and work together with two other gynecologists, obstetricians in our practice. Yes.
Oh,
But
that's
I'm
wonderful.
the only IBCLC from us
Ah, you're
three.
the
Yeah.
only IBCLC. Oh, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. Also, we were talking earlier offline, and of course, I was asking you some of these questions too. I wanted to know, what does it look like for you, and what do you do? And I know that you speak frequently, but you also are the vice president of the BDL. Perhaps you could tell everybody what this is and what you do for them.
BDL is that's the German Lactation Consultant Association. So I'm the vice president. Yes, and all the issues that lactation consultants have here, which isn't always easy because you have nurses that are IBCLC, you have midwives, you have doctors, and all these different health professionals who work in different settings, and we organize conferences. Every 2 years, every second year, we organize a conference for us all to with great speakers. And if an IBCLC has problems at work, like anything that can come, you can think of that could come up, they contact us and we try to help, or we know someone who could help.
Oh, that's wonderful. I actually was looking at your website today, although it's of the BDL website, and just again learning you have also sections for parents and for
Yes.
professionals. So, you provide parents some support on there as well. Is that what you do?
Yes, of course. On our website, you know how this works. Parents, there's a couple with a newborn baby, and they have problems breastfeeding, and they go online and they just Google how to find an IBCLC or a lactation consultant, and then they find our homepage, and then they can just put in their zip code and hopefully find an IBCLC in their area. And we have some information for mothers and couples, parents, and there's also the part of the homepage, the internal part where IBCLCs can post their issues.
Oh, good.
Yes.
Excellent. So it's you provide networking for IBCLCs as well if they do have any, if they need to
Yes.
do some troubleshooting. That's wonderful. That's excellent. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, so
Often that happens on Facebook too. You
yes,
know
of
that.
course.
But
Yes.
we have our homepage for that too,
Sure.
right?
No, that's great. That's a great resource. Well, thank you for sharing about what you're doing with BDL and the type of resources that are provided for your community. It's great to hear what's happening around the world. And you know, it's similar. You could be anywhere, Alexandra, you know, in the world, but this is what we do. This is how we practice, and we want to make sure that accurate information for our mothers connect them with an IBCLC so that they can get immediate help. These are important things, I think, that translates internationally, correct?
Yes, of course.
Yeah. Yeah,
And
it's
I
very
think
exciting.
it with problems, especially pain during breastfeeding, you can have that problem in Europe and in Africa and in South America. I'm afraid that's a topic. It's an issue everywhere,
Everywhere,
I'm
absolutely.
afraid.
Yeah,
Yeah.
absolutely. I think you know, that's what's going to translate about this presentation too, is the fact that there are mothers and parents suffering, you know, unnecessarily because they haven't been able to access adequate treatment, and perhaps they don't have somebody in their area. But at least for the people coming to this presentation, of course, lifelong learners at our Gold family here, so they will be interested to hear more about all the things that you have to share on pain during breastfeeding. So thank you so much, Alexandra Glass, for being here today.
Thank you, Fiona.
And thank you again to our listening audience for being with us here today. Don't forget to go to our website, check out all the dates and schedules coming up for our live Gold Lactation Conference. You'll see also that our live opening keynote is on April 1st, and you will be able to access that now for free. You can register for it and also share it with your colleagues and friends. Well, thank you again, and we'll look forward to seeing you all soon online. Bye-bye for now.